Okay, here it is. Hofner from someplace in the 60s with the Tolex finish. And anyway, it's not working too good. There's a backstory to this bass. I will talk about it. We will plug it in. This is from early mid 60s for sure. Someone will pipe off and let me know. I might look. It is really minty. I hate to say it. Not quite sure what they did. I think that's plywood covered with the Tolex, but that's usually, these all peeled and went the way of the dodo. This plays like ass. There's some tape under there, which I think are the adjustment wheels, but I guess they didn't realize that if you shimmed the neck a little bit, you could actually make this play, which is what we're going to do. This stuff that goes over top, the strings over the bridge, I'm not sure. Anyhow, let's plug it in. Woohoo! I can't wait to hear what noises it makes. So, a bit of the backstory is that the person that owns these does not play. They belong to his dad, and he inherited them. And we're going to make them as spanky as they can be. And then they're going to move on. But, I don't know. Ooh. Like to hear. Let's just see which ones are working. That makes a sound. That don't. Ew. Well, treble on, bass on. Okay, I get it. We can. So this is sort of more of a restoration than it is a repair. Not quite sure where it has a truss rod, but it's buried way in there behind this neck pickup. The neck's gonna have to come off to get this right anyway, because it's gonna need a shim. Like this is where it all went south, and they really didn't have the right measurement. The guy in charge of measuring was at the pub, I guess. I don't know. So, under this piece of black tape, which is probably screwed the Tolex, are something. Maybe it's hash. No, it's like I said, it's the two thumb wheels that are supposed to go under the bridge, which I'm impressed that someone took the time to save. So that's a good thing. We got those. That pops off. Oh. Oh. What? That's like a floating bridge? Yikes. That's crazy, huh? That'll make things more interesting. Put those aside. But anyway, they've got this little floating. That's probably why it's so buzzy.
Yeah.
I'll try and get a little tighter in here and show you. So this floats on a little wire right there. That's your bridge ground, and that's probably why I was like every time I touched it. Hopefully I can get that off. It really would be better to have that run back to here, don't you think? Like if you wanted to ground, I don't know, we're going to have to open it up because it's just a humming toaster at this point. But first, we're going to take the neck off of it and see what's in that truss roll. Truss roll hole. Yeah. Right, Dave. I'm thinking of egg rolls. Why does this make me want to think of egg rolls? I don't know. I'll get back to you. Well, the neck came off, and someone was proud enough to pencil their name on the back. What the hell is in there? Oh, doesn't look that bad. Let's see if we can make it straight. Well, I managed to scrounge up the right wrench. That's a weird one. 7mm. Come on, you can do it, Dave. It was on there a second ago. What the hell did you do? There it is. Righty, jetty, lefty, loosey. Ooh. Well, it does something. I hear crackling noises. Let's get a straight edge and figure out what's going on. What is going on right now? It appears that it has some back bow to it. Just release it. It works. I mean, that's cool. There's hope. Even released. A little bit of relief. Bring it back a bit. Ink, 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 ink. That's probably as straightish as it is going to get. Oh! I think someone likes me and they're in my pocket. We are just going to set this aside for a while because it works. And then we're going to get this part because I'm not sure if it does work. But we definitely have to open it all up and look, clean everything and figure it out. Because it's pretty scratchy. This ground wire is so dicey. It's like, how would they ever hope that to work? Because over time, the ground wire pushed itself into the Tolex plastic and probably really wasn't making contact, especially on a floating bridge. I'm going to maybe rethink that. There's a cavity here. This is here. The strings pass it. We're going to have a look. This is kind of scary because I'm trying to get a little tighter here so you can see. So that's the ground wire that was supposedly, hopefully, grounding the strings. Oh, we've got a capacitor from Germany. They're very proud to put their name on that. Right? The big ass freaking capacitor. A bunch of other schwa's. Like I said, why wouldn't you just ground that properly, right? A little wider here, sorry. Right? Well, that'd be work, right? You'd have to drill a hole from there to there and run a wire, ground that right. Okay. Well, I'll clean it up and think about it. I can definitely take that off. And she pretty much looks like a big chunk of mahogany to me. With some routes out of it to accommodate the wires. I was sort of wondering about this binding thing before I took it apart, but it looks like what they did is this is one chunk of wood, and they routed a channel all the way around the whole frickin' thing. Glued the Tolex to it, and this is where the two halves of the coating meet. Kind of neat. I mean, it's much easier to paint a guitar. I hate to break the news to you. Big messy cleanup on Isle Hofner. Wow. Tarnish is my name. Cleaning it is my game. Well, we'll get there eventually. Well, the metal bits are spanking up pretty good. And I'm not going to modify that ground wire. I'm going to leave it original. Because I just think those pickups are noisy single coil attempts at an electric instrument. But anyway, it's a bit of vintage stuff. And I'm sure someone that had one or knew of one, okay, back a million years ago when Christ was a cowboy, would get a big boner. Of course, that's the bass I had when I was a kid. I need that back. Well, I'm shining it up for you right now. It'll be for sale soon. You'll see. Well, that cleaned up fairly well. Let's clean up the neck. I'm going to figure out a neck shim. We're going to put the bridge back the way it's supposed to be with the adjustable thumb wheels, because they didn't know how to do a neck shim. And it's going to play as good as this could play. I don't even want to guess what year this is, like 1960. Too many. Let's clean up the crusty old frets, give it some Earl, and put it back together and see what happens. Oh, don't forget the neck shim, Dave. It's going to be like 3/4 inch thick. Tonight's sandwich is a stale croissant. Just so you know, let's put this turkey back together and see if it can fly. Oh wait, turkeys don't fly. Never mind. Based on previous observations, this thing's getting a serious neck shim. And oh, my window's open and it smells like skunk season. Wonderful. Batten down the hatches. Yeah, we got a skunk guy in the neighborhood. And my window's the only window open down here. Thank the Lord. You don't want to wake up at 5 in the morning with, my little window down here is the only one that's open. But you really don't want to wake up at 5 in the morning when Mr. Skunk has decided to do whatever he's doing. I can smell it. I'll stick my nose outside in a minute just to see how bad it is. Like, maybe it's under my frickin' porch. I don't know. Come on. Can't we all live together? Well, it's looking good. But as I measure things, this is a true short scale bass, 30 inches, 30 and a bit. That's where the bridge wants to live, with its winky little wire that sits under the bridge. I gotta get strings for it tomorrow. Stay tuned. I got strings. Short scale 77s. Standard gauge. Flat wounds. I think it's gonna turn out as good as it can turn out. Well, this whole thing's on hold because these are not true short scale strings. I'll measure the scale again. It is a true 30 inch. Not 30 and a half, which would make those work. The quest for a set of true short scale bass strings is on. And just to be certain I'm not losing it, that's a square 15 inches right at the 12th fret. It's 30 inches. Okay, bass string short scale research is on. Okay, we're going to try this again. These are supposed to work. So I really don't know what I'm going to do with a set of medium scale Rotosound flat wound strings. And if these don't work, then I'm going to go start drinking now. and it's only about 9 a.m. Okay. And I really wanted to put those roto sounds on here. Oh well. Well, I see a taper getting down the other end. And nope. Boned again.
Okay, well, third time is a charm for the Hofner Tolex bass. Just, you know, to clear my own brain, I just want to tell everybody that somewhere in the back of my head, I remembered that Hofner basses need Hofner strings. Everybody has improvised over the years, and I forgot that. And my head's sort of like after you hit 60, it's like a bad hard drive. I shouldn't say it's gone bad. It's just all in there. It's just like, wow, by the time I find the file. So anyway, the moral of the story is you need strings that are for a Hofner Beetle bass. This is the same scale. And we'll go down to the other end and I'll show you why. So what happens is they have these little skinny guitar type tuners. And every short scale set of strings, and we'll just say that everybody that's saying they're short scale, they're not short scale, they are 32 inch scale, which is not true short scale. That would be 30 inches or 30.5 inches. Anyhow, you see how it works? Look, they get all skinny right away. This is gonna be great. Give me 5 minutes and I can get this out of my house. So that's the deal. You see that the only thing that wraps around the tuner is the actual core of the string. And, yeah. That's how they work. Let's get them all on and make noise. So, before I go finishing this, there's a backstory, right? I live in the city of Toronto. Over 3 million people, plus suburbs. And other anomalies. Anyway, I go to the pro shop, which is actually around the corner from my house, amazingly enough, that actually sell Hofner basses. And I, after screwing up and trying other strings, I went, oh, now I remember, it has to be for a Hofner bass. So I go to the pro shop. And go, hey guys, I got a Hofner true 30 inch scale bass. And right away the guy behind the counter looks at me and goes, oh, those strings are really hard to get. Alright. Are you sure? And I went, yeah, it's a Hofner Tolex bass. It needs to... So immediately behind me on the wall is a brand new Hofner Beetle bass. Brand new. Brand freaking spanking new. He gets out the tape measure. He measures the scale length, just like I would do here. From there to there and from there to there. And goes, oh yeah, he goes, those are really hard to get. And then there's two other people behind the counter. Nurse sort of looking at their shoes. And I just said, hey, so what you're telling me is I can buy a brand new Beetle bass right over there off the wall. You would sell me that bass. And at the end of the sale, if I said, hey, have you got a new set of strings for this? You'd look at your shoes. Are you joking? No, this is it. This is the end of the world. And I actually searched around and had to order these online. They were not cheapo. I had to look around. Oh, look, my painting's getting better. I'm going to add some color to that later. Anyway, that's the deal. If you got a Beetle bass, don't try to cobble shitty strings into the tuners. I've seen this. I'll show you. what happens. So what happens is people get frustrated and they try to drill these out so they can use the strings that they think they'll work, but then the free part ends up in the nut and it just never works out, guys. So here we are, sort of at the end of this Megillah. No good deed goes unpunished. We ended up having to replace the output jack. This thing is noisy. And the output is like zippity nothing. There's no way to get the pickups closer to the strings. It's hummy as hell. I'm gonna go plug it into a real amp because sometimes these quacky things, I don't know, to me, I measured the pickup resistance and it's very low. This is all worn out. Every time you turn it, something else goes wrong. I did what I could. I'm gonna go plug it into a real amp. Hang on.
Yeah.
Well, it doesn't do all that hummy stuff, but this ain't a bass. Pickups are still a mile away from the strings. They have no output. I'm not sure what's going on in here. They make this whole replacement, I get that, but it doesn't help. You can see the pickups are anywhere. I don't know. No outy putty. What happens if I tap the pickups with a metal object? Do they actually even make noise? Not really. It's pretty dead. Wow. Okay, I quit this kind. This would be a restoration. These need to be rewound. I don't even think it would ever work, even just because, like, of that. Just like, oh my goodness. That's all I gotta say. Cheers, folks. Be good to each other.